So hey guys, welcome back to another lecture. As we practice in our vector lectures, like we are doing the addition, subtraction and a multiplication with manually, but we can do easily in Python by simply just typing some of the code here. So today we will having a look one of the most important topic in Python, that is vectors. So how we form a vector and how we calculate and do some of the operations in the vectors. So we're going to look at in a great detail way. So as I said, like a vector is a simple term that can be considered in a single dimensional array with respect to Python. So here we deal with the Python. Okay. So vector is a one dimensional array of list, and it occupies the elements in a similar manner in the Python list. So we have a similarity in the vectors. So they both are a list, kind of list. So to form an array, so we simply use we use numpy.array. We have a kind of open parenthesis and a closed one method to create a one dimensional array that is a vector. So as I said, like a vector is just a simply kind of this. Okay, yes. So first of all, we have to import a library. So what do you mean by a library? So you're going to get in a few further lectures, like I'm going to discuss one of the all the libraries which we have, like a pandas, numpy, matplotlib, sklearn and everything. I'm going to cover each and everything in the libraries lecture. So as of now, just remember so numpy is just a library and we import. So why we are importing? Because we are using that library to make operations in the here. So just we import this function. We simply use import function, and then we have a numpy out there. We just simply ask to have a list out there, and it's created a kind of list. So the numpy is a 5 word, but as a computer science students, we are so lazy, right? So we make aliasing. So we use as a aliasing the name into the shortcut, like this is also work. This is also works same, right? We just use aliasing for importing the numpy as a mp. So I was so lazy to write the numpy and type numpy, so I just make it mp, and you can make it any other, but the other people also should know. So most of the people use np, so we're going to stick with that. So as an example, like how we create a vector. So we just take a list out there. We just take a list, and then it's an array of numbers. So we just add array by using the numpy library. As I said, like we use np because we use alias in there, and then we simply, so why, what we have to be an array? List. So what is list? Like 10, 20, 30 and 50. Right, so it is going to be like the list to converting it list to vector. So how your vector? So we just printed that, and the vector is the vector created from a list. So we are created a vector from the list. So that's the vector here, 1, 10, 20, 30 and 40 and 50. So this is the vector. So we have it's a row vector. It's a kind of row vector. And how we create a column vector? Same, like we are taking four objects here, and just we have converted the list into the vector by using np.array, and just we print that, and this is a row vector, so it's just a column vector. So we have as we discussed in our previous lectures, we have some kind of operations out there. So what are operations? So the first one is the addition. So we have a vector plus vector addition. So I have taken two lists, list one and list 2, and I'm converting list to the arrays, and I'm converting the list to the arrays. So after that, I'm going to add. So I just called it as a vector add function, and I'm just adding these vector 1 and the vector 2 by a plus symbol, by a plus symbol. So here we print that. So we print the, what we are printing? The output of these two added vectors. So just they are matched or not. So we have to check like if the dimensions are matched, like as I said like previous lectures, like the 2×3 dimensions, like kind of stuff like so. So here we also check the dimensions. If they match, then it will give the output. Otherwise, it is undefined and we're going to get some kind of error. So I'll show you an example. Like I'm adding 10 out there, and we are getting the could not broadcast together with the shapes. Like we have a 5 out there and we have a 6, means the dimension didn't match over there. So you can understand, like we only add if the dimensions are matched, as I said. So after that we have a subtraction. So here also we have taken the two lists and we converted the list into arrays, and then we use here the addition vector. Here we use the addition. Here we use the subtraction. Here we use the subtraction. That's it. There is nothing else. And just we simply print that with the we name that operation like a vector sub, and just we simply that, and just we print that, and we're going to get the subtraction. So if we do manually, then we're going to have a vector, and then we have to take it manually, and we have to calculate all these operations, and we're going to add it and the final vector here. So but here it just we typing that, just within a fraction of seconds, just a fraction of it giving output. So if I add like a 6 out there and 70 out there, it just I'm typing 1 second, it is giving output in a just a fraction of seconds, milliseconds. Yes. So after that, as I said, now it's going to be very funny. So you can practice as many examples as you can until you have a good grip over this topic. So after that, we have something known as multiplication of two vectors. So so we have a two lists out there, and we just simply make them arrays, and then we have a star. So why we use star? In programming language, the star denotes multiplication. The star denotes multiplication. The star denotes the multiplication, and just we simply print that, and we getting the output. Like 10 into 1 10, 20 into 2 is 40, 90, 30 into 3 is 90, etc. So after that, after multiplication, we have something known as the division, right? So the process is all same. Like we can take directly an array also, but as an example, like I have taken this list because most of the aware of that, it's easy to create. Like if we have a A out there, if we have a B out there, it's simply easy to create, and then we convert into the arrays vectors, and then we have a operations out there. So here we have on the division. So this is called as a division. This slash command. After this hash, we use this slash command. After the hash, we use this slash command to have a division operation there. And just we simply print that, and we're going to get something like. So I'm so sorry, like it's totally alright. So I have taken the same numbers, so the output is same. So I have taken the different numbers now, and let's see. Yes, it's 10 10 10 10. So after that we have a vector dot product. So it's a vector dot product, means we have discussed about the dot product in our previous lectures and the cross product. Yes, so it's just a simple, like we have two vectors, and we use the dot product. So how we use the dot product? Like we simply had a dot, we simply have a full stop and a dot. So we simply full stop and dot over there, and then we mention this as a dot product, and we had operation on the dot product, and let's see how is your output going to be. And the output is 150. So as I discussed, like in a dot product we going to get the output as a scalar, right? So yes, so after this you can try as many examples as you can. So I hope you do that, because it's just a funny thing. So you can play it with around like, you can play with this, you can play with this. So after these are all operations, so you may get like, why we are using NumPy? Yes, so the NumPy is just a Python package. It just stands for the numerical Python. So just a NumPy means a numerical Python to have a operations on the numerical ways. It's just a library consisting of multi-dimensional arrays. So as I discussed in our previous lectures, like what do you mean by multi-dimensionals, how the linear algebra is going to have a high dimensional space, like etc., please check the previous lectures. And then we have a collection of routines and processing of arrays and etc. We have a lot of things out there. So as we discussed, you know, further lectures in the library's lectures, as a brief, like what is NumPy and how we use NumPy, and other libraries also, the pandas, matplotlib, scikit-learn, etc. So after that, the NumPy aims to provide an array object that is 50x faster than the traditional Python list. So why we are, so you may ask, like, for we are creating lists, then why we are converting into arrays? Because it is 50 times faster than, it is 50 times faster than the list. So that's why we use, it's a very powerful library. So, and the arrays are very frequently used in data science, machine learning, and many more, where the speed and the resources are very important. Why? Because the job is to reduce this time and have a good accuracy. Yes. So after that, you might ask, like, why the Python is faster than the list? Yes. So the answer is, like, the NumPy arrays are stored at one continuous place in a memory, unlike list. So like, it has a one continuous place, not a one fixed place, it has a continuous place, and the process can manipulate them very efficiently. So I hope you're understanding, like, this behavior is called as locality of reference in computer science, means it dividing the work into subparts. It's a kind of thing. So that is the main reason why the NumPy is faster than list. And also it is optimized to work with the latest CPU architectures. So to install that library, I have installed the NumPy library before, but to install that, we just simply use this, and then we're going to get, yes, so it's already installed in my computer, so it's just saying the already satisfied. But if you not install, then it's going to install. It's just a simple kind of thing, and you may ask Google or YouTube to how to install that and etc. So we just simply create, how we create the NumPy. So without taking the list and converting into the arrays, which we can directly take the arrays directly, like this. So it's a clear, like, we are putting the list in the arrays. That's it, bro. Like, you can have this or you can have this also. It just means calling in a different names, but both are same. Like, we just print the array and we can check the type of array. This is used to find what type of function we are using in this. And we can have a, like a, so I just print like true. So it's going to give a boolean value. So what is the true means? It's a boolean value. So it just give the type of its function. So that's, we use the type function. And after that, we're going to cover all about these NumPy lectures. Like, as I said, like, in a library's lectures, we have a detailed talk out there. So if I said now, it's kind of, if I said all these, we have a advanced learning. If we begin these machine learning lectures after completing these basic mathematics and probability, and then we're going to cover that, and there we can have a good understanding about the NumPy, pandas, and many more. So just go and research about what is NumPy and how we use in machine learning, etc. in a numpy.org, in a numpy.org. So until then, bye-bye. So I hope you enjoyed this lecture. If has, please like the video and share with your friends. So until then, bye-bye.